pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence for the sick, handicapped, departed, and the military community, military personnel of this community, particularly Skip Calusi, who is a faithful servant of this community, serving on council. Thank you. Roll call, please.
Michael Jordan.
Here.
Bruce Galucci.
Here.
William Henderson.
Here.
Neil Lyons.
Here.
Joseph Colosimo.
Here.
Galucci.
Here.
Bert Cherry.
Here.
Mayor Bethel Blazio.
Here.
Solicitor Thomas McDermott.
Here.
Engineer Joe Sykes.
Here.
Borough Manager Julie Collins.
Here.
Police Chief Chad King.
Well, here. Sort of.
Gary. Fire Chief William Chilio.
Here.
Southbridge EMS Dan Miller.
Here. We'll call our first visitor up, Mary Weiss.
Thank you very, very much, and I'll start with my end. And there will be stuff in between. I do want to wish you all a very, very Merry Christmas, a very happy New Year. But let's think about health, healthy New Year. And in addition to that, keeping costs down as much as you can. Unless you all want to have to get a new car next year. That's it. But Merry Christmas to you all. First of all, I do want to say that we were quite sad to lose Skip Calusi. Those of you who knew him probably never knew the amount of pain he was in these last 3 years. And anytime you'd say to him, "Hi, Skip, how are you?" he'd say, "I'm fine." But anyway, the back was too much for the heart. And he was still teaching the Bible that morning. So a great man from Bridgeville, another great man from Bridgeville, has passed away. I want to invite you all tomorrow night to learn more about Brooks in Bridgeville. Yes, I have a few of those left. It begins at 7 o'clock. It's over at the railroad station. And we're going to talk about C.P. Mayer Sr. and all he went through to finally get the brick, the quality of the brick that he wanted. And if you could dig down under a lot of the asphalt on our streets, you'd find a lot more brick streets out there. But if you're interested in the brick history, tomorrow night's a good guy, John Euler, because he has research on that man, pages and pages. We do have a few calendars left. I brought a few tonight. They're still $10 each. I think they're tremendous. Yes, I am prejudiced. I think they're terrific. You need to come in and see our White House Christmas tree. One of our members in Texas sent us replicas of the ornaments on the White House Christmas trees from 1980 to 2015. Then we have another first place winner over there in a Christmas tree from the Friends of the Library Christmas Tree Festival. The title of the tree will tell you the tree. Everything on that tree was made in Bridgeville, Pennsylvania, and they won the first place. We have some great creative people over there. You need to come and join. One other thing, and I skipped right on over it, but that's all right. But I do have calendars, a few. I do have the thing about tomorrow night's program. We'd love to see you all there. Thank you.
Thank you, Mary. And Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Laura Vitullo.
Do I need to call there, or is it all right if I sit out there?
If you'd like to.
It doesn't matter to me. I'm coming representing Armstrong's Express in Bridgeville, but I also am a patron of probably at least 7 different establishments here in the Bridgeville area. So I have both a perspective as a manager trying to run a business here, but also as a consumer trying to do business here. This new parking situation we have going on is not working. We are going to lose a tremendous amount of business. We already have. And we need to try to reassess this pay station program. Couple of ideas for thoughts. For example, we had a customer, 2 handicapped elderly couple came in. They go from a handicapped spot, which is supposed to be close to your facility. They got to take those scooters across the parking lot over to the pay station, then wheel their way all the way back around to the restaurant. That is absolutely absurd. That's just a small little microcosm of the problems that we're facing. 75 cents for my customers, LaBella Beans customers, to run in, pick up their food, and run back out. They're not going to do it. I've had people tell me, we are not coming down here anymore. It's blatant, it's not blatant. Lunchtime business, there's 2 kiosks out there. Lunchtime and dinner business, there could be 10 to 15 people deep at those kiosks. Some people have a half hour for lunch. They don't have 10 minutes to wait at the kiosks. And the kiosk, when you first come in, I've been at Armstrong for 10 years, and I've watched that parking lot a lot out of our windows. People fly into that parking lot. I'm telling you right now, that is a tragedy waiting to happen. A little kid who's lets go of his mom's hand while she's trying to press buttons, a group of people in line, somebody come flying around that corner like they do. It's not a good scene from that standpoint as well. Obviously, I'm concerned about it for our business because I am the manager. I'm trying to make sure our business stays good. I was just trying to patronize Dr. Mulling's facilities the other day. I'm lugging my dog across the parking lot in a pouring down rain trying to use this unuser-friendly machine. It is not user-friendly at all. And I'm thinking to myself, what are we doing here? It's just, I was downtown, I used that pay station downtown in 15 seconds and was gone and on my way. We really need to figure out how to address this problem, find maybe open parking for some. I don't know what the answer is. But all I've seen in the last 2-3 years from the parking authority is a money grab. They've taken what were sort of like free areas to park and turn them into parking spaces. We have people constantly asking our business to move quarter mile down the road to brand new facilities in South Fayette, free parking, abundant parking. Something to think about, because it's on our mind, and I know it's on our customers' mind. So I don't know what the solution is, but we need to talk about it.
Like I said, you mentioned the parking board, which is its own entity. They meet next Tuesday?
Mm-hmm. No, Monday, I believe.
Monday is Monday.
Yes, I was told to come here and there.
That's perfect, because I was going to say, I'm glad that you brought this to our attention. I will be at the meeting on Monday as well, because I would assume that you're going to give them the same information you just gave us. And I'll be. Yes, Mary?
I happen to concur with her. We have a woman who goes into a handicap slot who can barely make it from her car into our building. She's one of the ones that created the winning Christmas tree. Now, they suggested to me that she park down below at the kiosk, get out of her car, put the money in, or the information, and then go back up to the parking slot by the building and get out again. I'm sorry.
I don't know if you guys have any poll here, but has to be some heat put on the parking authority.
Absolutely. You have, between you and Bards over there, you should be able to put a lot of it. And
let me ask this question. I mean, I know they're a separate entity, obviously.
Yes, they are.
They operate.
Right.
Because I'm in complete agreement with you, and you're one of many people I've spoken to about it, including other business owners. And I experienced it myself. I mean, you have to memorize your license plate. And, I mean, I don't know my license plate number. I have to walk back at it, as did people who've been lying with me. I guess my biggest concern is that as us on council, I know it's a separate entity, and I'm aware of that, but I think this is now the second time in the last 2 years that something's happened with the parking authority that was detrimental to the Bridgeville citizens who then come here to talk to us, and I think it might be something that we're going to have some issues with moving forward. I mean, they raised the prices.
Last September.
And just assuming that was to buy the new fancy parking things that don't work, because whilst we could raise prices if we've done nothing different. So I think that's an issue, and I think that we as council need to keep an eye on this and potentially in the future have a slightly different line with this, because it is that is frustrating to me that we have this going on. And I don't like that we kind of don't have the, you know, because
it's actually two increases in the past.
Right.
Two. It went from 25 cents an hour to 25 cents for 20 minutes, and now it's a minimum of 75 cents.
Right.
So.
And isn't there like a minimum on credit cards on the machines?
$2.
$2.
It's $1 downtown.
Yeah.
Because I'm always here. I talked to the one guy that runs some of the parking authority, and he'll be like, well, my lender does this. They got $4. You know, so that, you know. Downtown, it's
easy $1. To say, yeah. So we're like so-and-so. And
if I thought that the system helped and benefited, I would. I'm all for change. I get that part.
It's
of
not
it.
A $2 minimum, bottom limit.
Well, yeah, that's what I've been told. I know, I mean, I don't, but that's what they told me.
Yeah.
And it's not beneficial. There's nothing. I don't know who benefits. I don't know where what is better about this system, except maybe for them, because now they don't have to wheel that thing around and collect quarters.
Does anyone know, are those machines, can they communicate with the new apps out there, like meter, feeder, thing? Can they be adapted to that?
Supposedly, yes.
The ones at Carnegie and Pittsburgh did.
I believe, that's what's Rich, please correct me if I'm incorrect, but I believe the parking authority is looking at getting an app for smartphones. There are apps that coordinate with the current system that the parking authority has, and I believe that they are looking very carefully at adopting one of those apps in the very near future.
Yeah, it'll be at our meeting next.
Right.
I mean, that could address a lot of that issue. You're one person, one meter. You know, you're at your car. It doesn't address the cost. That's something that
doesn't. No, address, no. Was that nobody?
Yeah, I was gonna say we have a.
And it doesn't address the fact that people want to for
just pick up
a business like Armstrong's or LaBella Bean, who are just going in there for pick up an order for 15 minutes.
Should
be able to quarter in and get out.
This cries out.
I know, Pat. I hear you.
To allow our customers 1 hour, 2 hours, maybe even as many as 3 or 4 hours of free parking, and place the burden for parking, the cost, on those people that wish to occupy spaces all day. Okay? It eliminates all of the issues that are being brought up. It eliminates the impediment to businesses in our community. It puts us on par with our competition in South Fayette and Collier. And it is relatively easy to implement. And it does not put the parking authority in a poor financial condition. I strongly recommend that the council and that the parking authority look at that idea.
One day.
I just want to say one thing also. A couple years ago, the reason they put those kiosk things in, people were complaining about the parking. That it was birds, other people. I guess they didn't like the parking meters. They jacked up the prices, and they went to the parking authority specifically asked to put the kiosk, if I'm not mistaken, right?
Yeah.
Right. So they got to fine-tune the things. I agree wholeheartedly with Mary about the handicapped people. That's terrible. I mean, those people can't do that. Money-wise, I don't park down there all that often when I do it. Put the money and forget about it. And don't they have the free parking during Christmas anymore, or they do?
Yeah, they just started today. For the last 2 weeks of the year. So and that's appreciated. I'm not even suggesting that it's free parking all the time, but I know probably 90% of my customers no longer put money in at all. They just run in and they say, hurry up, give me my food, and then they get out of here. You plus 75 cents. I mean, now you're not getting anything.
Better than the same thing.
Especially if you look at there's three or four people standing in line to pee, that's weigh the options.
Yeah. I'll take my chance.
Yeah.
Just some food for thought that we need to really contemplate, because the competition is only going to get more severe as South Bay continues to grow and develop. I mean, it's right there around the corner. And it's a quarter mile.
Going right up on the top of it. Constant reminder.
Yep.
Penny all vodka.
I'll bring it over. Thank you for your time. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Eric Schmidt, please.
I'm going to talk about a couple of things. Parking meters for one. Listen, the thunder was stolen there. But I will tell you that I work with this kind of equipment daily. I design touchscreen interfaces. And the problem with machines is the touchscreen, the capacitive glass, and the LCD are really large space apart. So I went to Burger's last week, and I was behind an older gentleman. He was struggling. Couldn't get it to work. He's like, he was real good sport about it, good spirit. He's like, I'm going to let you go. I don't want to hold you up. So I started trying to. I'm like, sir, it's not you. It's the machine. But the problem is the angle, the distance between the glass and the LCD is so far that when you're standing up, you think you're hitting one letter, but you're a letter above. You got to get down and look straight in at it to get it to work. I mean, usually when you repair a touchscreen phone or something, you order the glass and the LCD comes as one unit. The only reason to separate them is to save cost. It's just something you can do. Also, the ones in Carnegie and Pittsburgh, they have the physical keyboard. That's what makes it faster. That's why you're having a line of 15 people, like they're saying at lunch. I mean, it was only a few people when I was there, but it took one person like 2 minutes to get through it. But I had a hard time getting through it. Actually, I didn't want to take my credit card either. Didn't like reading it. Burke's looking. They never thought to take my money, but the machine wouldn't take it. So I'd go back to the car, get quarters, come back. So between me and the older gentleman there, it took us about 15 minutes just to get part. So what I would advise is you gotta try this equipment out before you install it. Somebody should have the user test. Or you should just say, you want what they have in Carnegie. It's 25 cents to park in Carnegie, by the way, for I think the first half hour. So that's something to consider too. What I would recommend is if there's like a grace period that you can, try. If you don't like it, get your money back. If anyone's do that, because these machines are a little bit on the cheap side. They're going to be trouble going in the future. So take it under advisement. Try to get better machines if you have time. The other thing is I see that my sewage bill is going up again. It goes up every year. I remember being here 2 years ago, and the rate was raised to match Alcosan. I think it was 561 2 years ago. They just raised it arbitrarily, 561 for the borough portion as well, just because they could get away with it. I understand there's a lot of work to be done. We're under obligations, EPA obligations, but everyone's under those obligations. So I started looking around. What's everyone else paying all around this? Give people perspective. Let's think of somewhere really expensive to live, like Boston, Massachusetts. We'll work nationally and then we'll come down locally. They're paying about $9.23 per 1,000 gallons total. We're paying 14 total, but the borough portion is about $6.29 or something like that. So that's Boston. That's one of the priciest places.
I'm sorry, what was the borough amount?
You guys have it here.
No.
It's like 14 total. 14.
So Boston, if you said 923.
It's like 923 per thousand.
That's the total, or that's the borough?
That's the total. Pittsburgh. It's a little more complicated than Pittsburgh, of course, but it's $3.99 per 1,000 gallons. There's a $4.58 a month fee, and then they multiply your usage by 7%. When you work out 6,000 gallons, about what I'm doing at my house, about $7 cheaper than Pittsburgh, than Bridgeville, just for sewage. You look at Dormont. Dormont's $4.50 for 1,000 gallons. You look at South Fayette, it's about $3.27 per 1,000 gallons, but it's a $12 a month fee, but it still works out to be about $6 cheaper than Bridgeville. Collier, $4.48 for 1,000 gallons, but it's a $6 fee. Still works out to be about $5 cheaper. I can go on and on. Baldwin, $5.29 per 1,000 gallons with a $6.75 fee. Still, it's about on par, actually, with us. But nonetheless, it seems like we're paying a lot more than our neighbors. We're paying more than cities like Boston, Cleveland's, like $10.43 per 1,000 gallons. I mean, why are we paying so much more per 1,000 gallons for sewage? I mean, the pipes in Cleveland, the pipes in Pittsburgh aren't that much older than the pipes in Bridgeville. It seems like we're not getting a bang for our buck, or we're trying to do too much at once. Maybe other municipalities aren't being as aggressive as we are. Maybe we need to reconsider how aggressive we're being. This doesn't seem like our neighbors are paying quite as much as we are. So, that's all I have.
Okay. Spit, did you check, because we were stitching, did you check how much Kennesburg pays and how much Cecil pays?
I looked at Peters, but they're not out of the county, so I didn't think it was appropriate. But Peters Township is $6.40 total.
But see, we have to look at a lot of things here. We have to look at the overall income. But Bridgeville and the southern community, even though they all come from the sewer, we have to make sure that we have to look at the overall income. We need this much, in my opinion. We need this much. And when you say you don't do too much, it's never too much. We should do a lot more.
We are
against the federal.
Everybody's under the same mandate. Everyone has the same mandate. And water and sewage is my largest utility. And I feel bad for people on fixed income because it's just going up and up and up.
I've been saying for years that the sewage bill is going to be at least triple of your utilities. And that's going to come there. And I'm sorry. The reason I said it because I've been involved too long. If we have to look at the overhaul of the southern municipality, we cannot make that comparison on one-on-one. We should look the entire overall. Right. Where the agent come, where the grants, et cetera. I'm sorry. I've been in too long and that if I don't say this, I feel guilty. I apologize.
No problem, Ian. You're fine. Dan Huff.
All right.
Well, thanks for the time and the opportunity here. It's really pleased to announce that we've got a Lions Club in Bridgeville serving the communities actually of Collier, Heidelberg, and South Fayette. We have 27 members that have signed up, and that's really fabulous for Lions Clubs. It's been a struggle, but not here. There's an awful lot of people who are willing to give their time to help those who are in need. So I'm inviting everybody to pay and come to our charter night, which is January 12th. I've got information here. And it's a Thursday. It's the Alpine Hunting and Fishing Club. And it's $29. But we're going to have some speakers. We're going to be giving out some of our money. The Downtown Club gave money to the Bridgeville Club. We're starting off to help out with the police force, defibrillators. I understand you've got a need for some for the cars. We don't know if it's two or three or whatever, but we've got some money. We can buy them and make sure they're compatible with the paddles that I understand that you can get. So we're going to be on January 12th. We can get a few of you to show up there. We're going to be giving you defibrillators. We'll find out how many you really need for your cars. We'll see what we can do. They're not cheap, but thank heavens we've got some money right now that we can do that.
Do you have somebody picked up for that?
What's that?
Do you have somebody you're working with emergency?
No, we're actually working right here with two of our members.
When they bought the one for instructors.
What was it? $1,200? $1,200? Sounds like more like two. But we'll get a start with it.
I was just talking with Dan, and he said that they're actually going with Phillips. And they're running about $1,100.
Roughly.
Roughly. That's just kind of what he can think of as of now, not to say that that's concrete.
No, I was just giving you an avenue, and I didn't think of the answer.
Yeah. And carbon monoxide detectors, I understand you give those out to people who are in need. We'll find out what would be a good supply for you to get you going. We'll take care of those for you too.
Thank you.
So we're here to help whoever needs. We're going to be working with a group called 412 Food Rescue to get food to the needy in this area. We just need to find out who they are. One of our members, Chuck Bloedel, has been working with the Veterans of Foreign Wars, and he's been doing that himself. So we're going to be able to pull together two or three charities and both help people with furniture and with other goods to help them wherever they need it. So there are contacts right here. I've got information about the event coming up on the 12th. We're also going to be calling on all the businesses in the area. Armstrong, where we at? We'll be over. And we're asking people to put some ads in our program or to buy in the sponsorships or donate some things that people can bid for. Because we're going to make that night a big charity fundraising night so that we can help a lot more people as we go along. So we're looking for members. Always looking for members, so hope some of you can find some time to join us because the more that we've got, people don't have time to give tons of their time. But if we can get 40 or 50 members in this club, and that's not outrageous from where I'm seeing, we can get people who can volunteer their time as they can, and we can serve more things. We'll be part of the community days, we'll be part of helping the historical society. We want to do everything that we can for the community. Need to know what that is. Anybody got any questions before I leave some information behind? Okay. I'm going to have this right over there on the table, or you want to keep it. I'm going to keep some of these things right here and some announcements. I'm going to leave that with you. And we also have anybody who wants to be a member, I've got some of my business cards I'm going to leave here. So, if you want to contact me for more information, we've got some of those as well. So, thank you all.
Thank you, Dan.
Yeah. Okay, that's good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, on to the regular meeting. Hey, minutes. A motion of the Borough Council regarding the minutes of November 14, 2006 regular meeting as submitted.
So moved.
Who was that? Bert and Bruce, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the minutes of the November 22, 2016 budget workshop meeting.
So moved.
Second.
Bill Henderson and Joe Colosimo. All those in favor? All those opposed? Motion carries. Ordinance number 993. Motion of the Borough Council regarding ordinance number 993, an ordinance amending the ordinance number 987 pertaining to the general rates charge for sewage service given to the customers of Allegheny County Sanitary Authority within the borough. The proposed 2006 rates are as follows. Alcosan rate 2016. $6.23 per 1,000 gallons. The borough rate is $5.61 per 1,000 gallons for a total of $11.84 per 1,000 gallons with an Alcosan service charge of $13.07 per quarter. The 2017 proposed rates are $6.92 per 1,000 gallons for the Alcosan rate, borough rate of
$6.23 per 1,000 gallons for a total of $13.15 per 1,000 gallons with an Alcasan service charge of $14.51 per quarter. Public hearing was held on December 12, 2016 at 6:30 to receive citizens' comments. Any discussion? Joe Verducci and Bruce Gallarducci. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Ordinance number 994. A motion of the Borough Council regarding ordinance number 994, an ordinance fixing the tax rate and levying borough taxes for the fiscal year of 2017 and reenacting all other revenue acts. Motion by Bruce Gallarducci and Burke Sheridan. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries.
Mike, can I just make a comment?
Yes, sir.
We had some discussion last month about this, and we have a lot going on in our community. A lot of reconstruction. Look at the South End. You look at some of our infrastructure is deteriorating. We have four parks to maintain. We've got a lot going on. And I took the liberty to pull up a lot of the millages from surrounding boroughs, and we are by far the lowest, save for one in Green Tree, which is very comparable. We need to think about raising our revenue in this community if we're going to continue to build out and support the construction going around. Obviously, it's not going to happen this year, and I may not be sitting up there next year, but if we're going to continue to thrive and build out our community, we have to think about that. Well, how long has it been since we raised taxes?
It's been, maybe about 7 years.
Yeah.
And then we lowered, we were at 7.5 mils. And then when the reassessments came in, we had to drop to 5.5 because you can't be over 5% as far as revenues go. So.
Eric, you were mentioning some of the communities that you saw the sewage rates were much lower, and those same communities, their millages are much higher. You know, so they're, you know, I'm only suggesting, and it might not be me up here next year, but we as an organization or as a board need to think about that, increasing our revenue. So, thanks.
Thank you, Bill. Resolution number 2016-11. A motion of the Borough Council regarding resolution number 2016-11, a resolution approving the budget for the fiscal year of 2017 and adopting the same. Discussion.
I'll make a motion to accept it and go with it.
Okay.
I'll make a motion to accept it. Somebody else will second, and then we can bring it out.
Okay. Is there a second?
What budget are we talking about?
Yeah,
there's
two.
Yeah, that's what
there's two in front of us. I know we had a long discussion at the workshop relative to the amount of people positioned on the public works. Bruce, do you want to talk about your feelings on that?
Yeah, At this point, I really don't want, if we hire somebody, we have to take $40,000 out of the director,
almost 61,000
out of the general fund to cover that employee, and I am one not in favor of that. I'd rather, as Bill says, I'd like to keep a balanced budget, and we want to look at some things next year in regards to the garbage fee and that, and moving that around. And we do have a lot coming about and a lot coming at us. So we have Chartier Street, which we got a $300,000 grant, correct? Or $200,000?
We have Chartier Street, we got a $300,000 grant, but we've got to take $288,000 from our reserves and put that towards that grant. In fact, PennDOT just contacted me and they want to have a meeting because they want to find out where all the money's coming from. So we've earmarked $288,000 for that. as far as the bridge goes, there's $200,000 that we've earmarked for, the surrounding communities have to assist in getting the bridge widened. We talked about what we thought we could afford, which was $200,000, so that is in addition to the $288,000. And then we applied for an adaptive lighting grant, that was approximately $180,000. And we have a matching, it's not a 50-50, but we have to have $53,320 set aside in case we get that grant, because we're going to have to match those funds. So last year we transferred $422,000 for projects that are going to happen this year that are separate. We have $46,538 in excess from last year. So this year we're going to have to transfer $494,782 from our reserves toward these projects that will be happening. The Chartier Street will be happening within the next year.
Yeah, or we lose it.
Yeah.
We lose our grant.
The contract only runs through August, and we're going to have to ask for an extension. But if that's going to be happening this year. And then PennDOT already has the design team out with the working on the bridge. So things will be happening pretty quickly. So in 2 years, we've had to transfer almost $900,000 out of the reserves. So I'm wary of transferring another $61,000 of the reserves at this time. Not that I don't want another employee, but that it's a lot of money at one time. I talked to Bill Phillips, who is still on our payroll. He does not retire until April 4th. As far as, since the lot is not working right now. And he stated that if we needed him to come in for any type of, if we had an issue with snow, that he would be glad to come in. And then we also have the option of, if we've got a tremendous snowstorm, we also have the option of an outside contractor, but that really happens. It's just been a few weeks since that happened. But that would be the only concern that I would have as far as our, you know, the lower number of employees, but Bill's available, so. And Bill Budd should be back probably by the beginning of February.
And with him retiring in April, will you be able to hire in April?
We still don't have the money in the budget. That in April would take us just $14,000 less than the $61,000, which isn't there. When I started the budget, I started it with him as an employee.
Sure.
And when I got done, I was almost $62,000 to the bad. I started with him as an employee, and I started with a police car. And to balance the budget, I had to take the police car out, and I had to take the public works employee out. So it's not that I didn't want to put them in, but the budget didn't balance.
So the grants are great. They're costing us money, and there's a price to pay here. You know, we went from 6 employees to 5 downstairs a couple years ago, and we remain at 5. I think all the development is great, but not at the expense of not having the appropriate staff in our township or our borough. So we need to, I echo my comments before, we need to consider how we're going to gain revenue to maintain the staffing that's appropriate here. So.
I talked to the public works director today, and he's off, but he stopped in, and I asked him if there are issues. I haven't had anyone tell me there are issues until this started, and now all of a sudden, yeah, they're shorthanded, that type of thing. But, you know, right now, the leaf machine is done, the brush grinder are done. We work on mainly snow, pothole patching, brush grinding, different things like that. Winter is a slower time for us. But I understand you wanting to bring the group up to 6. I couldn't do it in this budget, that's all. You know, I tried, but I couldn't do it.
I'm not suggesting that you could with what was in there.
Yeah.
I'm suggesting We need to look forward.
I need more revenue, so I can do that.
Yeah, don't, please don't.
Yeah.
My comments were directed at you, not buying money, so.
And I don't want anybody to think that I didn't want them, because I started out and looked them through everything, even all the benefits, everything. And then when I got done, I thought, and that was, you know, so the crews were disappointed and, you know, disappointed all the jobs.
Still have an answer, I mean, we have problems.
We're going after Wisconsin next year, but.
Yeah, but that is, I mean, we just, we wait for next year, or is that, there's nothing we can do?
Well, I think in talking to our public works director today, and knowing what we've had to work with in the past, it isn't a big problem for us. You can say it's a public safety issue as far as snow goes, but as I said, we can pull back Bill Phillips. Bill Bach will be back probably in February. And, you know, the guys are busy. They should be busy. So, and they're getting the work done. Could they get more work done with an additional employee? Well, sure they could. But we're getting the work done that absolutely needs to be done. Would I be opposed to raising taxes and hiring a new employee next year? No. You know, on the other hand, is always helpful.
Sure.
But can they function as they are now? Yes, they can.
Can I ask a question real quick? Because I might have just missed this one just in the last meeting. Obviously, something's been said that we're shorthanded. I mean, I know numbers-wise, we have less people, so obviously you have less going on, but you're kind of more involved with this on a daily basis, and it sounds like it doesn't seem like the issue's here, but I mean, I'm definitely hearing that you guys have heard otherwise. So I guess that's kind of what I'm asking, because I haven't heard the complaints, but clearly there has been something. Because if the person is dealing with it day-to-day is saying that we can handle it, it's being handled, is it do we have to?
Right.
I mean, I do agree with the problem with the future.
You know, it's issues like, the, for lack of a better term, the mayor's sidewalk down here. We're going into another winter, but that thing's never been resolved. If we had enough people in public works, possibly that could have been fixed over the summer. I know it's a state highway and it's all that.
Yeah.
It's things like that that concern me that we're not addressing, that if we had enough help, you know, that's the first thing you see when you come into Bridgeville from Collier. Your sidewalk's full of water that are going to freeze and probably frozen tonight or morning.
We actually just got, and Bill Blood had been working on this trying to get, we did the bids. First we did the bids because we were going to go the bid route. And then they came in at $101,000.
Right.
So in my report, we talked to a few cement contractors and found one that'll work with our public works department at a minimal cost of $1,850 with the public works department doing the work. But they have to wait. They're going to wait until spring to do it. So we've first had intention.
That's for the portion under the trestle.
Yeah, just under the trestle. I know you're working on
I thought we weren't allowed to do that or something. Wasn't there something going on where we had to be dealing with
under the trestle itself.
Under the trestle itself.
Under the trestle itself, but not in front of Don Melch's. That's another issue.
That will involve when we come to the chasing property.
I thought that was always something. Boy, if we could have done it, that would have been nothing small. So it wouldn't have made a difference this year.
I have to rely on running the department and the borough. I concur with Bill. I think it's inevitable. We're going to fight this whole.
Tonight, this year?
No, I mean coming up.
Next year. We as the finance committee have to.
I just want to make sure I know.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. We as the finance committee have a lot of stuff coming at us next year
that
we have to deal with. And this is all part of it. So.
Yeah, I agree. There's a lot. And the problem is like we have a $215,000 grant for McLaughlin Park. And we have money set aside for that. And some would say, well, do you really need to do it? Well, when you give a grant back, forget about getting one again for years and years and years to come. Because I even thought about that well, do we really need to do this project? It's hard to get grants from the DCNR when you don't use them.
Don't imagine.
You give something back, it'll be years and years and years, because we want to go to frontier departments. I was thinking about something like that, and I thought, no, that's not going to work. But the grants do cost us money. But if we don't get grants, then it's like we're not doing our job, So it's kind of a double-edged sword. We want to try to get money in, but it costs us money.
Okay, question on the motion.
First and second, yeah. We have a second.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'll be second. I totally agree with you.
All those in favor? All those opposed? Motion carries.
Exoneration of the 2013 Lincoln real estate taxes. Motion to the Borough Council regarding the exoneration of the Borough real estate tax collector and Anna Marie Parisi for the calendar year of 2013 uncollected real estate taxes in the amount of $9,359.65. A copy of the listing has been provided for review.
I'll move.
Joe Verducci.
Second.
And Bruce Cavendish. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Calendar year 2017 meeting advertising. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the following meeting dates for the calendar year 2017 and advertising the same. Council meetings will be held the second Monday of each month. Agenda meeting 6:30 p.m. and regular meeting 7 p.m. Bridgeville Parking Authority meetings will be held the third Monday of each month at 7:30 p.m. The Planning Commission meetings are scheduled the last Monday of each month at 7 p.m. during the months of January through April and June through October. The May meeting will be held on May 22nd, 2017. The November and December meetings will be combined to be held on December 4th, 2017. Zoning hearings will be scheduled as needed.
Take motion.
Motion by Bruce Gallarducci and second by Joe Colosimo. All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. 2017 Bridgeville Borough Sanitary Sewer Contract A, excavation contract. Bids were advertised and publicly opened on Friday, December 9th, 2016 at 10 a.m. in the Council Chambers for the 2017 Bridgeville Borough Sanitary Sewer Contract A, excavation with the following bid results. Solai Construction, 10% bid bond, amendment yes, bid of $212,655. Roto-Rooter Service Company, 10% bid bond, amendment yes, for amount of $240,610. State Pipe Services, 10% bid bond, amendment yes, $286,600. And A. Marine Contracting bid bond of 10%, amendment yes, bid of $395,985. Motion of the Borough Council awarding the bid to the lowest responsible bidder, Solai Construction, in the amount of $212,655, contingent upon review of all required documentation by engineer sites. Is there a motion?
Take a motion.
Bruce Gallarducci.
Second.
And Rick Cherry. All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries.
Mr. President.
Yes, sir. Ma'am. Sorry.
We would ask that council consider tabling the second item.
Okay.
After the bids came in, we've got $394,000 budgeted for point repairs. And as you can see, the 212 and 246,000 are over that amount. So we would like to table it until they take a look at the lining contract and see if they can make some adjustments to meet our budget criteria.
So contract B?
Contract
B. Okay.
Make a motion to table.
All right.
Second.
Motion by Mercuri and second by Bruce Valerici. All those in favor?
Aye.
2017 Bridgeville Borough Sanitary Sewer Contract C, CCTV and inspection. Bids were advertised and publicly opened on Friday, December 9th, 2016, at 10 a.m. in council chambers for the 2017 Bridgeville Borough Sanitary Sewer Contract C, CCTV and inspection of the following bid results. Contractor, AAA flexible pipe, 10% bid bond, amendment, yes, for the amount of $71,289.50. State pipe services, bid bond, 10%, amendment, yes, for the amount of $71,470.25. Inside pipe, bid bond, 10%, amendment, yes, for the amount of $77,296. And Robinson Pipe Cleaning, bid bond, 10%, amendment, yes, for the amount of $226,359. Motion to the council awarding the bid to the lowest responsible bidder, AKA flexible pipe, in the amount of $71,289.50, contingent upon reviewing all required documentation by engineer's sites.
So moved.
Bruce Valerici, Mercuri, comments?
I would ask the council table awarding this contract. And would be good enough to have a meeting before the next council meeting. I and some of the other council members who might be interested in looking more in depth, more in detail, might be able to get together on. I don't think there's any particular danger in tabling this until the January meeting. But I am correct, Joe, the contract, Joe cites that the contract can be awarded in January.
It could be, yes, that's what I'd like to say.
I'm gonna, Joe and Bert.
Mm-hmm.
The three of us are on a committee for the laterals and stuff. Would you be interested in meeting before our next meeting to go over this and table it? What?
Be happy to.
Joe?
Yeah.
Then do we need to rescind that vote? The award? We had a motion and a second to award it.
It didn't pass, it wouldn't pass, it has to.
I'll take it.
Rescind it, table seats. Table.
Okay. So we have to have a motion to table? I'll make a motion to table it.
I'll make a motion to table.
Bert made a motion, I'll second. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? And you go, Pat.
Thank you.
Bill list, motion to Borough Council regarding the 2016 bill list.
I'll move.
Joe Verducci. And Bruce Valerici, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Payrolls, motion of the Borough Council approving payrolls of December 16, 23, 30, 2016, and January 6, 2017.
So moved.
Bruce Valerici.
Second.
And Joe Colosimo, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Monthly reports. Motion to accept and pay any commission due the November 2016 real estate tax collector report.
I'll move.
Joe Verducci.
Second.
And Bruce Valerici. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Accept the October 2016 financial report.
All those.
Joe Verducci. Second, Bruce Valerici, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion to accept the November 2016 police report.
I'll move.
Second.
Bill Henderson and Joe Colosimo, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries.
Mike, one comment on it?
Yes.
I worked with the mayor and the police department to add a column in that report for us. And it's a 12-month average. So as you look at that, you will be able to see some of the spikes in the results of the police department. So take a look at it, and if something jumps out, let us know.
All right, thank you. And finally, a motion to accept the November 2016 zoning report.
So moved.
Bert Cherry and Joe Clark. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Committee reports, administration. Finance, Joe.
Well, as you can see, we've had many, many discussions over the last month, if not 2 months. Already, thank you for all your hard work for the budget. Definitely, the finance committee is going to have to meet. A lot of great words there, and it's just something that we need to discuss and figure out as a borough how we can make sure that we can operate at full function.
Thank you. Parks and Recreation?
No report.
No report. Public Works, I think, Bruce. Public Safety, Bill.
One thing, Mike, we're talking, Mayor and I kicked this around. If you looked in the Bridgeville News this week, there was an article from Heidelberg about parking and how they're dealing with people parking for 8 hours at a time on the street and jumping on buses and going into the city. We have some issues around town, and this is an area that I think we need to look at, what they've done down there, and scale back, as they say, allowing people to park at length like that in our community and leave, and not create opportunities for the businesses to be able to travel. So we'll look at that in committee. I would like to, come up with some solution or something that we can do similarly here.
Well, I know I'll be at the parking board. I'm sure the mayor will be at the parking board meeting next Monday. And there'll be plenty to talk about there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thanks, Bill. Pat?
Late at night. It was very, very nice. And I want to specifically thank Chief Chilio and the fire department. The ladder truck was a spectacular idea, and my compliments. It was just a wonderful, wonderful thing. And if anyone else saw pictures, but it was just beautiful. I'm sorry that Mr. Arndt has already left, but they did a fantastic job in decorating the park. And it was just a wonderful evening, so thank you. Thanksgiving Day, our chief was patrolling the town and responded to a robbery at the Gulf Station. That is not an uncommon, his response is not uncommon. Fortunately, robberies are uncommon in our community. What transpired following his response gained some attention, I believe, worldwide. To put it simply, he called out the perpetrator on social media, and the perpetrator is now in custody, and I believe that charges are pending. So it's a very good ending to a bad situation. Other than that, I hope that everyone has a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And I look forward to meeting with the committee. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Chad's not here, but do you have anything?
Just would like to wish you all a Merry Christmas.
Thank you very much.
Safe and Happy New Year.
That's all. So, sir.
Tear.
I have nothing to report other than my gratitude for the privilege of serving you, and Merry Christmas as well.
Engineer Sykes?
Thank you, Mr. President. A couple things here on the issue before we cover the sewer work. The road repairs will be done in the spring. The McLaughlin Run Park Phase 2, we had the required conference call with the DCNR for the grant in the amount of $215,500 for Phase 2. The improvements will include a new parking lot, restroom upgrades, and pavilion improvements. The agreement has been executed with the DCNR, and we're in the process of completing the design and bidding documents.
They must approve the design and bidding documents prior to the product being placed out for bid. I'm anticipating a winter bidding of the product, so we're looking to get the construction plans and specifications to the DCR for review and approval before the end of the year. Nothing new in the Washington and James development. I believe they're waiting for the design standards in order so that they can complete their design. And then nothing new on the Chartiers, Washington, and Chartiers Creek intersection. So that's all I have. I wish everybody a Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Jim. Same to you. Fire Chief.
Just that there's going to be a meeting scheduled regarding Chartiers. I'm just wondering, did you get something?
Thank you.
Let me see. Do you have a call?
Oh, no, I didn't.
Okay.
Fire Chief, will Julio.
Thank you, Mr. President. You guys have our report from November. Just a couple minor things that everybody's seen. We had the incident on Ramsey Avenue, but it went well, and you know, she's okay. Can't say much about that thing because we really can't by HIPAA, but she is okay. Can't give the details about it, really, it's honestly. Just like to thank everybody for their participation that day, from the police, us, and the EMS. The other thing is, we actually yesterday morning were assisting Green Tree too on that fire up at Foster Plaza. We spent most of the evening yesterday up there. Last I got on a good note, on the 18th is Santa comes around town, Mr. and Mrs. Claus, so be coming around during the football game. Since they're away, we know people will be home. That'd be a good thing. And just like everybody else, and from the fire department, please have a safe and happy holidays.
Thank you very much, Bill. South Bridge, Dan?
Not much to report. Again, just the Ramsey Avenue incident. I'd like to commend the police department and fire department on their activities in that day. They, two members of their departments actually are true heroes that day, so. We do think they did a nice job, and want to compliment them on their actions. So, and hopefully you don't see us on the holidays.
Not personal,
work related.
Becky's not here from the library. Borough manager.
I'm providing a written report if anyone has any questions.
Old business. And do business.
I guess so.
Yes.
Mr. President, we've talked with several of the other members, and I've talked with some folks out there about the opportunity to interact maybe a little closer with some of the planning commissions, the parking authority. Tonight is a good segue into that, right? I mean, there's some issues out there in the community reference to parking. And the suggestion that we've talked about in the past was rotating these authorities and commissions into the council meeting for a brief presentation quarterly. The whole planning commission doesn't have to show up, the whole parking authority doesn't have to show up, but put them on our agenda. They give us a brief synopsis of what's going on in our world. We can share ideas. I think it would be a mutually rewarding interaction, and I think we can all grow from it. So
it's a really good idea.
And it's a great time to do it. We're rolling into 2017, if we can get it on the agenda.
Yeah, we have the library delegate every meeting on here, and we don't have to have a library delegate every meeting. Right. Becky came to one couple of meetings ago. They have a nice,
awesome.
Yeah, really nice information on where they're at financially, and it was very important to us. But we don't know, you know, a lot of times we don't get a chance to get to a meeting, whatever. That's a great idea, Bill.
I can try to send them.
That'd be great.
In one rotation.
We can also go to their meetings too.
I hear you. Like I said.
Yep, you're right. I mean, that would probably be about, 10 meetings a month for us, maybe.
What's also amazing, it isn't just for us too, Joe. It's for
public consumption.
Yeah. TV, the audience, of course.
Any other new business?
That's all right.
I also. The news stories, the press that our guys got this week was fantastic. Great job. Congratulations on it. You guys be proud of your people.
We are.
Yeah.
Barry.
Wish everybody a Merry Christmas, safe holidays, and got a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Second, all those in favor?
Aye.
Close.